Hello everyone. Have you ever visited to the monuments or great historical places? How do you know about them? Let us learn about them today by studying the past. What is a history? History is a study of past. The word history comes from the Greek word historia, which means learning or knowing by inquiry. History is the story of people who lived in early times. History is made up of events that occurred in the past. To know and fully understand the world we live in, we have to be aware of its past. Why we have to study history? The study of past is important to understand the present. History is a continuous story of one event leading to another. The present cannot be understood without understanding the past. To know and fully understand the world we live in, we have to be aware of its past. History is generally divided into three time periods: prehistory, protohistory, and history. Let us learn about prehistory. In this period, writing had not been invented. Hence, there was no written record of this period. Our knowledge is based on archaeology. What do you mean by archaeology? Archaeologists are people who help us to understand the past. Archaeologists dig deep into the ground and dig out the remains of the past. These physical remains, such as pots, jewelry, tools, coins, bones, etc., help them to know about the past. Next, we have protohistory. Protohistory period was the time for which we have a written record. They are very few and still cannot be read because they are into the different symbols or in signs which we cannot understand. Archaeological sources are the main source of information of this period also. An example of this period is Indus Valley period. The third time period is history. The time period after the invention of written is known as history. We have written records from this period. Early writing was done on rocks, pillars, copper plates, clay tablets, palm leaves, etc. Over the years, many of the evidences have been destroyed. The remaining ones are a rich source of information. You know, when this period has been happened, let us see now. Anno Domini and before Christ is called as BC, and AD and CE, that is Common Era. BC or BCE, that is before Common Era. Before the Jesus Christ, we call it as BC, that is before Common Era, and AD, Anno Domini, is called as after Jesus born. Do you know why early people used to live near the river? Let us know how the geographical features played an important role in ancient period. History is studied geographically. Geography plays an important role in the history of India. India has diverse geographical features. There are high mountains, hot deserts, fertile rivers, valleys, and numerous rivers. The Himalayan mountains in the north act as a natural barrier between India and Central Asia. The passes in these mountains have acted as a route to people like soldiers, merchants, traders, travelers, scholars, and have often crossed these passes and traveled from place to place for trading purpose also. They have brought new ideas, customs, and habits that have been made our culture rich. Why did people travel from one place to another place in ancient times? The Indus and the Ganga plains are very fertile regions. So is the valley of river Narmada. These river valleys were areas people settled first. This was because The river provides sufficient water for all their needs. The land near rivers was very fertile. People could grow crops easily. The river served as a means of transport. On the other hand, areas where the environment is favorable are densely populated. Let us recap what all we have learned in this lesson. We learned about water's history, why to study history, dates in history, time frame in history, prehistory, protohistory, history, and geographical framework.